Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ginna Escobar, and I'm District 5. I've been in the area for 23 years and counting, and I'd like to thank all of you for coming and all the concerned residents of our wonderful city. I'd like to thank the Chamber for holding this wonderful forum for all of us, our moderator and our city officials, and the candidates for coming, to which will be a night of a lot of information and a lot of positive feedback from our residents. A little bit about me is that I've been around here for 23 years. I'm a product of Pomona. I love this city. I am a product of all the education. I went to the local schools. And I've noticed that in the past few years that our city is having a negative downslope. We're going through some hardships fiscally, emotionally, and physically. And what we need to do is obviously start by putting Pomona back to basics. What it is having communication, being accessible, being accountable, and having that and fostering that sense of community that we have somehow lost. Pomona is a beautiful city. It's a diamond in the rough. We have beautiful areas, and unfortunately, with one negative thing, such as crime or gangs, the city gets canceled out. We lose it. We need to exact all of our beautification efforts. We need to start by improving, by listening to our residents, by advocating for our residents, for communicating with our residents, and actually working as a liaison with businesses. We need to create incentives to make businesses happy. We need to work with the businesses that are thriving in the area, and we need to work with the chamber, and we need to work with all of the businesses in the area to attract incentives and to have out-of-town visiting, have a revenue circulating in the area, and bring back Pomona on top. What I can offer is all of that. With effective communication, we can bring about effective solutions, and that's why I am running for a city that I love very dearly. Taxes, because when we have our residents losing their homes because they can't even pay, we need to think in utilitarianistic point of view versus in a affluent manner. What we need to do is actually work and rally with our companies and our businesses that are coming to Pomona. Just like Mr. Rodriguez said, we need to find out what's going on, what are the negative drawbacks that is actually taking our city away. We have a lot of tax issues, and individuals need to come, and we need to somehow motivate people to come and spend their out-of-tax money. The revenue that comes in and circulates makes for a better Pomona, and what we need to do is obviously work with the liaison, make sure our businesses thrive, and make sure that we can not tax, but rather improve the visitation and circulation of revenue into the city. Aside from being a volunteer at numerous convalescent and rehabilitation centers and treating cancer, friends or patients, and working with the numerous preschools and elementary schools in my district and in the beautiful city that we all live in, I have also done my duties as an individual. I have gone to school, gotten my education, and now I've been able to bring back what I want to help with the city. My communication skills, my advocacy, my ears, my heart, and soul, and all the work that I can bring to it is obviously by promoting public safety, by making sure our communication efforts are exacted, and also involving the community, by promoting accountability, accessibility, and a sense of community. And that is what I brought to my district. Thank you.